Welcome to Helmet Fischer. Today we'll show you how to quickly and easily set up your MP0 coating thickness gauge. You have chosen a model of our measuring instrument family, MP0 R. With our pocket instruments, you can measure coating thicknesses on ferrous and non-ferrous metal-based materials non-destructively, easily, and precisely. The dual scope version of this instrument can be used for all these applications. The permascope version can be used to measure non-magnetic coatings on magnetic metal-based materials such as zinc, chrome, paint, paint on steel, or iron. The isoscope version allows measurements of electrically insulating coatings on non-ferrous metals such as paint or anodized coatings on aluminum. The instrument models are available with built-in probe or permanently connected cable probe in axial or angular versions. All models have the same intuitively simple user interface and a rotating graphic display. The MP0 R instruments have a USB interface while the MP0 does not. The MP0 R devices also offer additional evaluation functions. Now we'll show you how to start up your instrument step by step and be ready to use immediately. There are only a few steps. Open the instrument case and insert the two batteries into the battery compartment on the back of the device. Now the device can be switched on. To do this, press the multifunction button with the printed symbol. The graphic display lights up and the cal and menu tabs appear. In order to be able to measure correctly, the measuring instrument must be calibrated to the sample. Why is this? The coating thickness measurement is mainly influenced by the following variables. Physical properties of the base material of the sample, such as the magnetizability, permeability, or electrical conductivity. The geometrical design of the sample, such as the thickness of the base material. The curvature of the sample, such as a cylindrical shape. The position of the measuring point on the sample, i.e. the distance to the edge, a hole, a shoulder, or a step. And the surface roughness. For a correct measurement of the coating thickness, the measuring device and the probe must detect the characteristics of the sample. This is done with an instrument adjustment or correction calibration. With the help of an uncoated comparison part and one or two calibration foils, the influencing variables are recorded in order to compensate for them in future measurements. This gives you the maximum possible precision. There are different types of corrective calibrations. In one-point calibration, a calibration foil gives the best measurement accuracy in a narrow film thickness range around the specified foil thickness. In two-point calibration, two calibration foils give the best measurement accuracy in the film thickness range limited by the two calibration foils. Simple calibration. Calibration of the measuring system with an already coated reference part or calibration standard of known coating thickness greater than 200 microns. Please note that simple calibration provides a less accurate match to the base material than calibration with an uncoated reference part. Only use simple calibration if you have no possibility of procuring an uncoated reference part of just the base material only. In the video example, we show a one-point calibration on a steel plate for the measurement task of 75 micron coating on iron. After switching on the measuring instrument, please carry out a corrective calibration on your uncoated sample. To do this, pull up the cal function, select the function calibration with the arrow keys, and confirm with OK. In the next step, the standardization, carry out at least 5 measurements on the uncoated sample. First, place the housing foot and then the measuring probe. After each measurement, lift the instrument at least 1 to 2 inches from the sample before taking the next measurement. Confirm the measurements with OK. Then place the calibration foil on the uncoated sample and perform at least 5 measurements again. Pull pull up the set function to set the target value of the calibration foil using the arrow keys. Then press OK once. For a two-point calibration, a second foil can now be measured. For one-point calibration, this is not necessary. The corrective calibration can be completed with OK. The measuring instrument confirms that the corrective calibration has been carried out successfully. Please confirm with OK. In the next step, check the corrective calibration by re-measuring the calibration foil on the uncoated sample. Now the gauge is set and calibrated, so you can start taking measurements. After a series of measurements, you may want to determine the mean value or other statistical characteristic values. To do this, select the result function in the results tab. If there are still measured values in the device memory, you can delete them with the function delete all readings in the register delete. The compact measuring instruments of the MP0 and MP0R series are the perfect solution for fast, simple, and precise coating thickness measurement. The menu navigation of the MP0 and MP0R instruments is intuitive and does not require much training. However, if you still have questions, you can find more information in our user manual or contact your application specialist. You can also book a product training with us. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on LinkedIn.